next group of credits in site selection and planning is associated with heat island effect. There are two credits associated with heat island effect: credit 6, heat island reduction non-roof, and credit 7, heat island reduction roof. In this recording, we'll first discuss what is heat island effect, the reasons for heat island effect, significance of mitigating heat island effect, mitigation measures for heat island effect, and finally, compliance requirements for the credits associated with heat island effect. First, let us understand what is heat island effect. Heat island effect is basically the temperature difference or thermal gradient between urban areas and nearby rural areas. So it is basically the temperature difference between urban area and nearby rural areas. This picture clearly illustrates heat island effect. You can see that the urban area, that is the cities, have higher temperatures compared to nearby rural areas. The cities here record around 92 degree Fahrenheit, whereas the nearby rural areas record 85 degree Fahrenheit. Research shows that cities can be 3 to 10 degrees hotter than nearby rural areas. We understood that heat island effect is the temperature difference between urban area and nearby rural area. Now let us understand the reasons for heat island effect. In cities or urban areas, the surfaces exposed to solar radiation are hardscape surfaces like concrete and asphalt. Concrete and asphalt has very high thermal capacity, that is, it can absorb the heat, store a significant part of the solar radiation, and release it as a thermal energy back to the atmosphere. Thermal energy means heat energy. So it increases the ambient temperature surrounding the area. On the other hand, in rural areas, surfaces exposed to solar radiation are vegetated. We know that plants and trees consume water by evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration means evaporation plus transpiration. Evaporation causes cooling effect, and very less thermal energy is absorbed by the surfaces. Hence, we have the temperature difference between urban area and nearby rural area. The temperature difference can be up to 10 degrees Celsius. Heat island effect results in heat-related sickness and higher cooling energy demand. Hence, it is important to mitigate heat island effect. Heat island effect can be mitigated by three strategies. Number one, reduce hardscape area and increase vegetation. We'll discuss about these strategies in detail. And second strategy, shade hardscape surfaces. And the third strategy is to use high SRI coating. The third strategy is to use high SRI coating. Let us discuss these strategies in detail now. So the first strategy is to reduce the hardscape and increase vegetation. Most of the hardscape surfaces is because of the roof. So conventional roof can be replaced by vegetated roof. That reduces a significant amount of hardscape surfaces that is exposed to sun. So consider replacing conventional roof by vegetated roof. That is the first strategy. And hardscape surfaces such as parking can be replaced by open grid pavement. Consider open grid pavement for parking, walkways, roadways, etc. Hardscape surfaces can also be shaded by structures, trees, or solar panels. Ensure that when you are shading by structures, the roof of the structure should also be mitigated for heat island effect as well. The next strategy is to use high SRI coating. First, let us understand what is SRI. SRI is an abbreviation of solar reflective index. SRI stands for solar reflective index, and it is the ability of a surface to reject heat. It is the ability of a surface to reject heat. Let us understand this term further deeper, solar reflective index. So to understand this, let us see what happens when solar radiation falls on a surface. When solar radiation falls on a surface, a part of solar radiation is reflected. A part of solar radiation is reflected. It is called as solar reflectance. And you should understand this, the reflected solar radiation goes into the space. It does not go into the atmosphere, it goes into the space directly. The remaining solar radiation is absorbed. The remaining solar radiation is absorbed by the material. The part of the absorbed radiation is emitted back into the atmosphere. So this is basically emitted as a heat wave. This is called as thermal emitters. And a part of the absorbed solar radiation is transmitted inside the space. To summarize, four things will happen when solar radiation falls on a surface. Number one, solar reflectance. A part of the radiation will be reflected directly into the space. That is called as solar reflectance. Number two, absorption. The remaining radiation will be absorbed by the surface. The absorbed radiation will be either transmitted into atmosphere through thermal emittance. That is number three. It will be either released into atmosphere as thermal emittance, or it will be released into the space as transmitters. So these are the four phenomena that will happen when solar radiation falls on the surface. Number one, solar reflectance. Number two, absorption. Number three, thermal emittance. And number four, solar transmission. Let us now go back to the definition of solar refractive index. Solar refractive index is the ability of a surface to reject heat. Solar refractive index is the ability of a surface to reject heat. For example, if the solar reflectance is 90%, then only 10% of the solar radiation is remaining to be absorbed, emitted thermally, and transmitted inside the space. Here is a comparison of SRI for different materials. Gray EPDM and gray asphalt are conventional materials. These are conventional materials. Conventional materials. So you can see that conventional materials have lesser solar reflectance and higher infrared emittance, and hence the SRI is lesser. Whereas high SRI coating such as PVC white and two coats of white coating, they have higher reflectance, 83.83 and 0.85. They have a solar refractive index of 104. So to summarize, for a material to have higher solar refractive index, both solar reflectance and emittance should be higher. High SRI coating can very well be used in flat roof or low sloped roof, because the reflected radiation will go into the sky directly. It is not going to produce any glare. Whereas on sloped roof or non-roof surfaces such as parking or driveways, high SRI coating may produce a glare. Imagine this roof coated with very high SRI coating. It will create a glare. So for sloped roof and non-roof surfaces, the SRI shall be between 29 to 64 and not greater than 64. Let us now discuss about the compliance requirement of the credit. There are two credits associated with heat island reduction. Credit 6 is about heat island reduction in non-roof, and credit 7 is about heat island reduction in roof. The intent of the credit is very much relevant to the name. The intent is to reduce the heat island effect. For the roof, projects should implement either vegetated roof or high SRI coating or combination of both. Credits are awarded based on the area of vegetated roof and high SRI coating and the combination of both. Projects can get up to 2 points. When it comes to non-roof surfaces such as parking, roadways and walkways, projects can incorporate multiple strategies such as shading of hardscape surfaces with existing trees or new trees. When it is new trees, the trees should be able to give a shade within 5 to 8 years of planting, and at the time of occupancy, the trees should be already, the saplings or tree should be already planted. Projects can also use open reclaimments or grass pavers and they can also use high SRI coating. In this case, the SRI should be between 29 to 64. Based on area of non-roof surfaces, these strategies are incorporated, points are awarded. To summarize, we started with understanding heat island effect. Then we discussed about reasons for heat island effect. Going forward, we discussed the significance of mitigating heat island effect. We discussed various mitigation measures of heat island effect. And finally, we discussed the compliance requirements for 2 credits under heat island effect. Thank you.